Good afternoon. We'll go ahead and get started. I think there might be a few more seats down here if anybody else wants to try to. We got a packed house, both here inside the Ramsey Center Hospitality Room. Glad to have everyone here with the weather way it is outside. So glad you're here. And, of course, all of those watching with our video stream, so glad to have you guys tuned in here as well as we have a very exciting day here from Catamount Country. Do want to say that for our media folks, we immediately following our remarks, we'll have a quick little breakout session, some one-on-one time with our new athletic director. So we'll have that. No questions here. We'll do that immediately following. But here this afternoon, we'll have remarks from our search committee chair, Ms. Ivy Gibson. We'll also have remarks from our chancellor, Dr. Brown. And then we'll also have our introduction of our new athletic director on a very exciting day here in Cullowhee. So at this time, I'd ask our search chair committee chairperson to come up, Ms. Ivy Gibson.
Good afternoon, and welcome to an exciting day for the future of WCU athletics. I want to welcome all of you here. I also want to welcome our folks who are watching via live stream. And thank you for being here on this snowy Friday afternoon. And what an exciting end to the week, right? I could not be happier with the search and with the outcome. The announcement today marks a new chapter for Catamount Athletics, a chapter that I'm excited and proud to be a part of. So in December, I was appointed chair of the search committee for the new director of athletics. And along with me, there were 14 other folks, many of which are here in the audience today. Maya Beard, she supported us as the admin support. We had John Brannon, senior football athlete, double majoring in marketing and sports management. We had Dan Brooks, Catamount Board of Directors, Joe Crocker, who's an alumni and former athlete. We had Karen Glover, head coach of the women's volleyball team, Malia Habel, Catamount Board of Directors, Stacy Miller, Associate Athletic Director for Student Success, Ben Pendry, Executive Director of Advancement Services, Jake Robinson, Catamount Board of Directors, former men's basketball player, Kevin Stanberry, Catamount Board of Directors, Dr. David Tyler, who serves as the chair of the University Athletics Committee and also an associate professor in sports management, Mike Wade, a former football player and two-time All-American, Melissa Wargo, who is the university's chief of staff, Jim Wood, who's the Catamount Board of Directors president. And these folks are dedicated. They were a joy to work with. In early January, we were given a charge to complete our search by the end of February. So here we are on nearly the last day of February, and luckily we had an announcement. But it couldn't have been done without the folks on the search committee. They love WCU athletics, and they love the university. And they worked really hard over the last few weeks to carry out the chancellor's charge. They graciously dedicated their time and their energy to finding the perfect person to fill the role of athletic director. And I'm proud to say that we accomplished that goal. The competition was fierce, however. There were over 60 people that were interested in the position or who applied. Those candidates included sitting ADs, associate ADs, and other athletics administrators, former coaches and athletes, university advancement and development professionals, managers of athletics-related businesses, and officials with governing boards and associations. So the search committee reviewed all the qualified applicants and narrowed the list down to six. On Sunday, February 23rd, which was just this past Sunday, we met with those six extremely qualified candidates in Charlotte for airport interviews. And we narrowed those down to finalists that came to campus this week. And at that time, it was time for Chancellor Brown to make her hard decision. Today, I'm excited to say that we have found our new athletic director. And I know I'm not the important person here, so I'm gonna turn over the remarks to Chancellor Brown so that she can introduce you to the new athletic director. Thank you all.
Thank you. Great day to be a Catamount, right? Absolutely, 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 absolutely. Thank you, Ivy. Thank you very much. And thank you to the members of Catamount Nation who are here today and who are watching online. This is a big day in the life of Western Carolina University, and a big day for the Catamount Athletics Program as we welcome our new Director of Athletics home. Before I ask our new AD to come to the podium, I have a few people that I'd like to thank. First, I would like to thank Mike Byers for agreeing to provide leadership to the Athletics Department for the past few months. I know Mike is here, and he's probably standing someplace in the back. There he is, Mike. Thank you very much. Thank you, thank you. I also again want to thank Ivy Gibson for her superb leadership of this search committee. Without you, I think, chairing the search committee, it wouldn't have run as efficiently. So thank you very much, Ivy. Thank you. I also want to thank all the members of the search committee for working so fast and efficiently to bring forward a strong slate of candidates. Would all the members of the search committee who are here today with us stand, or if you're standing, wave your hand so that we can give you a big round of applause. I see a lot of you out there. Please stand. Please stand. Wonderful. Wonderful. Thank you very much. I realize that I gave you a pretty difficult task back on January the 6th when I delivered my charge for this committee. I asked you to find an extraordinary leader to guide us into the next era of athletics here at Western Carolina University. I asked you to find someone who understands that athletics serves as the front porch to the university. I asked you to find someone who understands that athletics provides our students, alumni, faculty, staff, and just as importantly, our community members, something to be proud of and to support. I asked you to find a leader for athletics department who can build a team of coaches and professional staff that will help our student athletes. Many of you are here today, right? Student athletes, I see you all. Thank you for being here. Clap, come on, let's give our student athletes. A lot of them are here today. I asked you to find a student, find a leader for our athletics department who can build a team of coaches and professional staff that will help our student athletes find the same level of success in athletic competitions that they have had also in academically in the recent years. I asked you to find someone with significant experience in the realm of athletics fundraising as we begin to implement our athletics facilities master plan and to start to work on some of the construction and renovation projects that are proposed in that plan. I think that you have found exactly who we were looking for when you brought forward our next athletics director. I also want to take time to thank Todd Turner and the Collegiate Sports Associates for their outstanding work in assisting the search committee. Todd, you and your colleagues have been wonderful teammates throughout this process. Thank you, Todd, and everyone else. Thank you. Now, the reason that we are here today to let you meet our next director of athletics. Alex Gary has served as a senior associate athletics director for development at Oregon State University since September of 2017. In that role, he has been in the athletics chief of development officer and has been a member of the athletic department's executive team with shared responsibility for the department budget of $85 million, 150 employees, and more than 500 student athletes. Alex is directly responsible for the 16-person athletics development team at Oregon State and oversaw a record fundraising year of nearly $26 million last year. Prior to joining Oregon State, he served as an associate athletics director for the development and external relations at the University of Michigan or at the University of Maryland from 2014 to 2017. He's also held development positions at the University of Michigan and the University of North Carolina at Charlotte. Alex is a native of Knoxville, Tennessee, and grew up in Charlotte, North Carolina. His parents, David and Sheila Gary, are here with us today. David and Sheila, would you wave or stand up? Stand up, please. Stand up. I thought thought that I was going to have to explain to them this purple and gold thing. You should see the purple coat that Sheila wore in today. I'm like, oh my goodness gracious. I was like, wow. Okay. And so I know you're very proud parents today, this afternoon, and it's obvious you like purple and gold because you're going to be seeing Alex wearing a lot of that coming forward. Also joining with the family today is Jackie and Jimmy Covington. Jackie and Jimmy, would you please stand up, please, as well? Jackie and Jimmy, thank you. Thank you to the family. Here she is. I've got Sheila Blakely here. She is a friend, a sorority sister, classmate of Sheila. Thank you for being here. Yes, yes. And we have Brandon and Jalen. Brandon and Jalen, stand up for us here today. Here we go. They got to miss school today. They think this is pretty cool, right? Right? You know? So this is awesome. So thank you all. Alex first came to Western Carolina University as a member of the Catamount baseball team, playing outfield during the 2002, 2003, and 2004 season. He earned a Southern Conference Player of the Week honors in March of 2004 and was a member of the Catamounts regular season and Southern Conference Tournament Championship baseball team in 2003, participating in the NCAA Tournament Regionals that year. Although he currently works on the West Coast, Alex has maintained close ties with his baseball teammates. In fact, Alex tells me that three of his former Catamount teammates will be serving as his groomsmen in his upcoming wedding to his fiancée, Katie, who is with us today. Katie, please stand up. I believe that Alex's professional experience in the Pac-12 and the Big Ten, which are major collegiate athletics conferences, combined with his personal familiarity with Western Carolina University as a former student athlete, make him a perfect fit to take over the helm of the Catamount Athletics Program. In short, this hire is a grand slam home run, and it touches all bases. I had to get that one in there. I'm sorry, Alex. I tried. Anyway, now, ladies and gentlemen, meet the next director of the Catamount Athletics Program, Mr. Alex Gary.
Mentors of mine over time, as I've kind of navigated this whole world of intercollegiate athletics, have said to me, when you think about taking an athletic director's position, one of the most important things is finding a chancellor or university president that really understands the value of athletics on your college campus. And I've only known Dr. Brown a couple of days, but it's very evident that she certainly understands that value. So that alone, if nothing else, makes this a great opportunity for my family and I. There are a couple of people here that I do want to acknowledge. First and foremost, Dr. Brown mentioned this, a couple of my groomsmen in my upcoming wedding, a couple of former baseball players for the Catamounts. Where Rod Golston? There he is, Rod Golston and Chris Davis. Thank you so much for coming all the way across the state to be here with me today. It really means a lot. Kelly also mentioned my beautiful fiance, Katie. Thank you so very much for being here with me the last few days, and thank you so much for your support. My little cousins, Jalen and Braden, which are filming me right now, which is very comfortable. Thank you guys for being here. My beautiful parents, David and Sheila. I truly feel like I have the best parents in the world, and thank you for your prayers over the years. Thank you for your thoughts over the years. And I think I can finally relinquish you from paying my cell phone bill now. So, I know that was something you're looking forward to. There have been a lot of thank yous today, but I certainly also want to recognize and thank Dr. Brown for her trust, the Western Carolina University Board of Trustees, Ivy Gibson and the entire search committee that's been recognized before, as well as Todd Turner, Drew Turner at Collegiate Sports Associates. One other person that I want to thank who's not here today, and she's probably going to not really understand why I'm thanking her, is a lady named Judy Rose. Judy was the director of athletics at the University of North Carolina Charlotte when we met about 13 years ago. And I sat down with her in her office and I said, Judy, how do you get to do this whole thing of intercollegiate athletics? So tell me how to get there. What's the secret sauce? The first thing she said is, be careful what you wish for. And then she just gave me a couple of nuggets, and everything that she's advised me to do from that time I've done and has led me to be here today. So I want to thank her. This university means a lot to me. I came here, I remember my family dropped me off in front of Leatherwood Hall in the fall of 2001, and I had no idea what to expect, but I was excited for something new. I was a 17-year-old knucklehead, as my dad would say, and left years later with nothing but open possibilities. This place definitely shapes young people. It really does. Young people that come here to our university to compete athletically and academically, but not only compete at the Division I level, but say they came here with a chance to win at the Division I level. Western Carolina deserves a consistent winner across all of our sports. And as a former student athlete, I want to be able to be part of helping build that across all of our programs. Competing consistently at the top takes growth. It takes growth in the way that we look at what success looks like, how we evaluate what real success looks like. It takes growth and investment in our facilities, infrastructure, and other resources for our student athletes. One of the reasons I came back to Western Carolina, other than the fact that I truly love this place, was that this university has already made a commitment to that growth. But the vision to bring Western Carolina back into a level of competitive excellence across the board will take partnership. Partnership from alumni, partnership from students, partnership for the entire community. And I wouldn't be here if I didn't think we could get that done. There's a lot of things here in Cullowhee to be proud of, but there's still a lot more to do. First, I want to make sure that our student athletes continue the fantastic work that they've done in the classroom under the leadership of Stacy Miller and our academic advisors. There's been fantastic work that's been done. But I also want to make sure that we're taking care of you for the 40, 50 years of your working career after you leave Cullowhee. Taking care of you, making sure that you're prepared socially, economically, and mentally for what's to come. Students are why we're here on this campus, and you'll always come first. We need to grow our resources so that our coaches and our student athletes will be able to fund their programs at a level that gives them an opportunity to compete in the Southern Conference. It's a lot easier to hold individuals accountable to certain standards and certain expectations when they have the resources to be able to support what they're trying to do. Lastly, we need to build. We need to provide our student athletes with safe facilities so they can train and prepare in, our coaches with facilities that they can recruit to and teach in, and facilities that will make our campus, our community, and our alumni proud of what we have here in Cullowhee. This university has great leadership, excellent faculty, and devoted students. Together we can build a consistently highly competitive program here across the board at Western Carolina. And as a former student athlete, I'm excited to help make that happen. Thank you.
Thanks a lot. At this time, we'll have our media breakout just to the left in the little alcove there, and then we'll get Mr. Gary back with you guys as soon as possible. Thank you so much for being here. Appreciate everybody coming out, and, of course, everybody that was watching on our online stream today. Thank you.